morning. Good morning to all the participants. The topic for today is decision-making techniques under marginal costing principle. The Academy is privileged to have Dr. G. Vijay Kumar, faculty from session as today's speaker. Now over to you, sir, for the discussion. Good morning. Welcome and thanks to each of you for being here. I hope the session would be helpful and for your, especially keeping LDC in view. This has been I'm audible for all of you. Today I'm audible.
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
Okay, thank you. So I'll take it forward. So after the session is over, we'll keep some time for your question and answers and clarifications. I'll take it forward. Okay, thank you once again. Let me start. Actually, the session is on decision taking, marginal costing, how it will help in decision making. Before that, keeping LDC in view and any concrete exams, I want you all to have some idea about management accounting. So little introduction to management accounting, I will not waste much time. Just see what is all about. See, accounting is the day-to-day, any business organization, any organization will make their accounting, which is called financial accounting. Where financial accounting ends, management accounting starts. Management accounting and costing are branches of accounting. So how helpful they are in decisions, etc. will tell you the techniques. So, management accounting, as I already mentioned, it is a branch of accounting. It provides information to management according to its needs. So whatever the need is there, according to it provide. So management wants how much profit, how much bonus to give, how much dividend to be declared, what is the profit. Based on the profit, they will give. So many things. Whatever information is required to the management to its needs, it will be ready. It is more concerned with information that helps it in its basic functions of planning, organizing and control. Management must set goals for the organization, evaluate various means by which they can be achieved and select the best alternative. It must employ scarce resources in the best possible. Today the resources are very, very scarce. That is the reason for management techniques are used. If the resources are not scarce, there is no question of any decision making technique. You can take any decision. If that is okay, you can go ahead, or if it is bad, you dump it and take another one. Because the resources are scarce, in the best possible manner, and take care that there is no significant deviations from the plans. So this is how you employ your scarce resources. It also helps one to know how the organization is faring when compared to its performance in the past. So we would also know how was the past, so what is the present, so how should be the future. So this management accounting will help in all these areas. So as in the words of Charles T. Holmgren, management accounting is a process of identification. You identify, then measurement, then accumulate the information, analyze it, prepare preparation and interpretation of, and communication of the information that assists the executive in fulfilling organization. So this is how the management accounting does. It measures, it accumulates the information, it analyzes, it interprets and communicate to the top management for decision making. So that is the main thing about management. So there are characteristics. From the definition itself, we know that what is first providing accounting information. So management accounting is based on accounting information. It involves the presentation of information in a way it suits management for decision making. Again, everything is that only by making decision making, planning, forecast. So that is one, providing accounting information. Please remember that. Second is what? It studies the cause and effect. What is the cause and what is effect? It studies for any effect, there should be a cause. So what is that cause and effect analysis it does? Management accounting is done with the study of cause and effect relations of various accounting information. Now today we are having economy is down, economy is bad. Why? Because of COVID. So there is a cause. The reason for this, that cause is that. So like that, for everything, that cause and effect analysis has to be done. So management accounting helps in that. Use of special technique and concept. Management accounting uses special techniques and concept. There are two very important techniques management accounting uses. That is called marginal costing technique and standard costing technique. These are the two techniques which out of this I am going to take up marginal costing, which is, you know, here. The special techniques include financial planning analysis, standard costing, marginal costing. So all the three, four, I am taking marginal costing today. So that is why I made this understanding how management accounting is useful. Helps in taking important decisions. Management provides required information, which in turn helps the management to take right decisions. Then one more characteristic is achieving outcome. In management accounting, the accounting information is analyzed and used in such a way that it helps in achieving organizational objectives more effectively and economically. That is very important. See, it should be effective and it should be economical. So that is one of the main objectives of the management accounting. You will know, you get your objectives are achieved effectively and economically. The actual performance is compared with the standard set. So this is where standard costing is used. Maybe in some part of the day, in the session, I will just touch upon standard costing. If there are any deviations and variations, corrective steps are taken. For example, I'll just tell you a small example for, you know, standards. So if for doing a particular job or a particular this thing, process, you say this is a standard cost should be 1 lakh. But the actual cost has become 1 lakh 50. So there's a variation, there's a deviation or variation of 50,000. So we would like the reason for this deviation. So this is possible only with the help of standard costing. So we'll know what is the standard cost, what is actual cost, what is the variation, and what are the reasons for variation. Whether it is unfavorable. That is adverse. We call it as adverse or favorable, the variance. So no fixed norms are allowed. In management accounting, specified rules are not followed like financial accounting. See, financial, for each and every debit, there must be a corresponding. That is the rule of financial accounting. We have some golden rules. Real account, personal account, nominal account, CSS, debit what comes in, credit what goes, like that. These are the rules. But in management accounting, specified rules are not followed. Even though the various techniques used are same, they differ in application from concern to concern. So every concern has its own rules and sub-rules for analyzing the data. So what exactly you need, nothing is tailor-made. It is only we have to fix according to our requirement, our need. So management accounting helps. The information is there. How you have to use it, it all decides by the management. Increase the efficiency. The main object of management accounting is to increase the efficiency of the organization by constant performance and everything. In some ways, information and not it gives the information. Decision making is left to the management. So the management account will simply supply the required information to the management. It is for the management to take proper decision basing on the accounting information supplied by them. So information is there. So what decision you have to take, you have to see. So one of the small examples of decision making which I am going to touch upon is, so you should make or buy. A product has to be made in the factory or not made. You should make it or buy. So such a decision, so the information is given to you. So when I take the touch upon that subtopic, I will explain you. So how important it is for a decision making, the information. So information is very critical. If the information is wrong, the decision will be wrong. If the information is accurate, the decision will be almost accurate. So that is very important characteristic of management economy is on supplying information. Concerned with forecast. So what is the forecasting? We have the information. It is concerned with the future. It helps the management for proper planning and forecasting. The information is supplied mainly with the object of helping the management for taking future. So this year my profit is so much. So I have the information. So next year I forecast my profit for 5% more or 10% more. Like a student, when he gets his progress report, he feels that in a particular subject he got less mark. So next time what he has to do, he has to put in more effort. So this is how the management accounting helps the in giving the information for future planning and forecast. One of the very important things. That will be possible only with the information. Emphasis on the nature of various elements. It is concerned with the understanding of the nature of various costs involved for accurate forecast of the future. It is both an art and science. So it is based on facts, hence it is regarded as science. But any forecasting will involve the subjectiveness of the forecaster, hence it can be termed as science. So it's both an art and science management technique. It is very important. It is based on the facts. Means once the information is there, the factual information is there, that is science. How to take a decision, how to forecast it and all, keeping something in your view, that is your, it's an art. It is an art. So scope is also almost the same like this. So scope of financial accounting, which I've already told you, cost accounting is one, and budgeting and forecasting. These are the three very important, scope of management accounting. The areas which from the scope is what? Financial accounting, cost and budget. Inventory control is also equally, these days it has taken a very important role. Reporting is part of it. Interpretation of the data, tax accounting, internal audit, budgetary control, control procedures and methods. So these are all very, very important. I will share, you will get this PPT, you can go through this because I don't want to waste time on that. Which I want to touch upon the techniques. So, as already I mentioned characteristics, we have got some objective. Main objective or the primary objective of management accounting is to help the management in maximize profit or minimize the loss. That is what. Every businessman wants to maximize the profits or minimize the loss. So, how? That is the main objective. Every businessman, if you ask him what he wants more profit. And if he wants to reduce the loss. If a student, he wants to say, I want to get first class, I want to get distinction, I want. So something like that. Everyone wants that only. So the following are the important objectives of the management. So planning and policy for. The main objective of management accounting is to provide necessary information to the man for formulation of plans and policies. This is one objective. Helps in controlling performance. Management accounting techniques like standard costing, and budgetary control. See, what is standard cost? What is the standard cost of making a product? Then when you compare with actual cost may be more. So what you will try to do, you will control that cost. Budgetary control. You have budgeted for a project so much. If you exceeded the budget, then you have to control that. So this is how the objective of management accounting goes. It helps in controlling the performance. Helpful in organizing. Helps in interpretation of financial information. Motivates the employees, helpful in taking decisions, reporting to management, maximization of wealth, minimization of tax burden. So these are all the important objectives. Everyone knows about it, but it's all part of it. Now I'm coming to the importance of management accounting. Management needs information. Every management needs information. For what? For efficient planning and effective organization. In the process, for what purpose? To service the customers, to increase in efficiency, maximize profit, industrialization, control cost. So this is what, in a nutshell, these are all the importance of management. So now, the topic, actually the today's topic is techniques of decision making. In that I am dealing in depth marginal costing, including breaking point and cost, volume, profit. So first, I just give a small example. However, I'm going to make an example later on. See, we are having a factory. In the factory, we are making a product. So the product is to be made or not to be. That is make or buy decision. So how it sounds very simple, but how important it is. So if you want to make a product, the cost of that is 10 rupees. The cost of the product is 10 rupees. And if the same is available in the market for 9 rupees. I hope I am audible for all of you. Everyone is okay. Once in a day, someone will keep telling yes, okay? So that I am not cut off from people. Just in between, I am audible or not, if you tell, I will be happy. Okay. Thanks. Outside people, you know. So what I was trying to tell, if you are making a product, it is 10 rupees if you make. The same product is available for 9 rupees. So you may say, if it instead of making it for 9-10 rupees, why don't you make for 9 rupees? So that is not simple, I told you. Before you take the decision to buy it, we should first check up, is the quality same? Is the size of the product the same? Is the guarantee same? Is the warranty same? Is after the sale service is same? Is it going to, there is a rate contract, running contract, so many things. As we go inside, we can understand. But this many features, this many factors you have to consider. With all this, now imagine what we are making the product 10 rupees, the same which is available for 9 rupees. Okay, 9 rupees if I am making it available, we are thinking of buying it. But please, all of you, while I am teaching, you can make some points, make some doubts, make some points and keep. When we come for an interactive session or something, you can clarify. Here I will make it more clear to you, if not now. So you can make some points and keep it ready for the discussion session. Okay. Then, if it is 9 rupees, I told na, the size is same, the make is same, the quality, everything is same. Then should you make it or buy it? Still, we should not make it, buy it, because we should always, in our costing, we have two types of costing. One is called fixed cost, one is called variable cost, which I am going to discuss earlier. But for the time being, as I am just taking this example to take it further, without knowing the difference between a fixed cost and a variable cost, we should not take. So now, what I am trying to tell, if you are making the product, the fixed cost is 2 rupees and the variable cost is 8 rupees. So our total cost of 10 rupees comprises of 2. We have to classify the cost into fixed cost and variable cost. The fixed cost element is 2 rupees and the variable cost is 8 rupees. If you are not going to make the product, you will not spend on variable cost, but the fixed cost will remain with you. So if you are having 2 rupees fixed cost with you, if you buy for 9 rupees, the 9 rupees purchasing price and 2 rupees fixed cost, it is going to cost you 11 rupees, which is not good for you to buy the product. Instead, you will make the product, which is going to cost 10. So this is very important. This is how the marginal costing techniques are used. So some people have the doubt, sir, when you are not making the product, from where do you get this fixed cost? Please understand, all of you, some authors have put it fixed cost as a shadow cost. Whether you make the product or not make the product, whether you make, now for example, you are all, so many participants are there. Now, as of now, there are 63, earlier were 20, 30, 40, 50, whether 30, 40, 50, 60, another 10 joined, 70 or 80. My class timing, my teaching time will be the same. So some kind of fixed cost will be the same, whether it is 2 people or 10 people or 60 or 70. So when you are making the product, there are certain things which are fixed in nature. Whether you make the product or not, the fixed cost will remain same. So it varies from organization to organization, but some kind of fixed cost will be there. So that fixed cost of 2 rupees is there if you make it. And when you buy that 9 rupees, the 9 plus 2 fixed cost of 2 will become 11. So in this case, you should not buy it, you should make it. So this is how the techniques of decision making are used. As I take it further, we'll see. Okay. So the decisions are so many things are. make or buy, accept or reject, continue or drop a product, product mix, profit planning, fixation of selling price, key factor. So this all I will try to relate with the railway product. Railway products are nothing but you should consider the AC 2 tier, AC 3 tier, AC first class, like that I'll put it as product, okay? So should you make it or buy it like that? Means in the sense, if in a workshop there are some products are there, should you make it or buy it? Is the question. I'll come back on each thing, I'll make one small example in it. So now, for all this make or buy, accept or reject, continue or drop a product, product mix, profit planning, fixation of selling price, key factor or limiting factor, for all these things, we need to have marginal costing. You should understand what is marginal costing. Marginal costing is change in total cost due to increase or decrease of one unit or output. Okay, this is very important for you to understand. Marginal cost is change in total cost due to increase or decrease. Suppose if you are making one product for 10 rupees. Okay, the fixed cost is 2 rupees and the variable cost is 8. So what will be the cost for 2 units, you know? The fixed cost will be 2 only, but the variable cost is, for 1 it is 8, for 2 it is 16. 16 plus 2 it will become 8, but it will not be 20 rupees. I am clear, the total cost that due to increase or decrease in 1 unit or output. See, for 1 unit, the variable cost is 8 rupees, the fixed cost is 2 rupees. If you are making 2 units, the variable cost will change. So variable cost will become 16, but the fixed cost will remain 2 only. So 2 plus 6, if you are making 3, 8 threes are 24 rupees plus 2, 26, but it won't become 30. So this is very important point you should have. It is a technique to show the effect on net profit if we classify the total cost into variable cost and fixed cost. So whenever you are doing marginal costing technique or using it, I want all of you to understand the organization should be in a position to classify their total cost into variable cost and fixed. If you do not know the in the total cost, what is your variable element and fixed element, you cannot do marginal costing, you cannot use marginal costing technique. That is very important point. You make a note, if you are having any note, when I take the discussion time, I will make it more clear to you. The ascertainment of marginal cost and the effect on profit of changes in volume or type of output by differentiating between fixed. That is very, very important. I am going on stressing the difference between fixed cost and variable cost. What is fixed cost? What is variable cost? In simple language, fixed cost will not change with the change in output. Variable cost is that cost which changes with the change in output. That is what it is all about. I'll make it more clear to you. So marginal costing is also referred as variable costing, direct costing, differential costing. But this slight, however, these terms are not the same in all results. The slight change is there. So as I take it forward, I'll make it more clear to you and make you understand. Marginal costing is a technique which distinguishes between fixed and please do remember, it's very important. Marginal costing is a technique wherein it differentiates, it classifies the total cost into fixed cost and variable cost. That is very important. In marginal cost is always equal to variable cost or cost, the same thing what I'm trying. Okay. Now, one more point you have to understand in marginal costing, which I'm going to touch upon, is a break-even point. In simple language, a break-even point is a point where there is no profit, no loss. See, sir, you are starting an industry, your cost is, say, means I'll put it like your revenues. Revenues means your total sales. Your total sales is equal to total cost. Suppose your cost is 100 rupees and your sales is 100 rupees. There's no profit, no loss. So that situation is called a break-even point. A break-even point is a point where there's no profit, no loss. So technically, I'm putting it on the slide. A break-even point may be defined as that point of sales volume, means whatever sales, at which the total revenue is equal to total. Means total revenue is your total sales. Sales is 1 lakh and your total cost of the sales is also 1 lakh. So there's no profit, no loss. It is a point of no profit, no loss. Break-even point can be calculated in units of return. In units means, suppose I ask some example. Suppose I am selling some calculators daily. If I sell one calculator daily, I break even, I say. Suppose someone is asking, sir, how many calculators you have to sell daily to break even? I said, I have to sell one calculator. The same question is posed by another student. He says, sir, how much rupee? So I have to say that every day I have to sell 500 rupees. 500 rupees are one calculator or same? One calculator is, I am selling for 500. So one unit or 500. One calculator or 500 is more than the same. So one is in units and one is in value. That is the meaning of break-even point. Make some points, all of you, if I try to change it. It is called contribution because it contributes towards fixed cost. So, very important difference is what? Sales, whatever the sales, from the sales if you minus the variable cost, the leftover thing is called contribution. Why it is called contribution? Because it will contribute towards your fixed cost. Every organization will have two elements, fixed cost and variable cost. Suppose fixed cost is say 20,000, variable cost is say 1 lakh, and you sold for 1 lakh 50. So from month, if you minus 1 lakh, it will be 50,000 is left. From the 50,000, you minus the fixed cost 20,000, so 30,000 is a profit. So you have to remember this very important difference. Contribution, we call it because it contributes towards fixed cost. It is the difference between sales and variable cost. It can be expressed in terms of what? Units and absolutes. Just now I told you. Absolute term means what? You are selling 500 rupees. What? One calculator, it means the same in terms of units and absolute terms. It can calculate it as under. It can calculate it like this also. Contribution is what? Sales minus variable cost, or contribution is equal to profit plus fixed cost. So this, if all of you have one screenshot, you can take it and keep it with you. So when I'm doing the problem, this will be of some help for you to understand. This is a marginal costing. This is a formulas we should use. We should remember. Sales minus variable cost is equal to fixed cost plus profit. This is, I put it as mother equation. Then sales minus variable cost is contribution. Just now I told you in this. Sales minus variable cost is contribution. Same thing I am putting here. Sales minus variable cost is equal to fixed cost plus profit, or the other way, sales minus variable cost is called. Indirectly, it means what? Variation is equal to what? Fixed cost plus profit. It means the same. Then we have got another form of break-even point in terms of in. How you can find out break-even point? You put fixed cost divided by sales minus variable cost in units. So if the problem is given in per unit, selling price per unit and variable cost per unit, you take this formula and use it. Fixed cost, the total fixed cost divided by selling price minus variable cost per unit, or total fixed cost divided by contribution. This is per unit in terms of. If they give in terms of rupees, fixed cost is so much, sales is so much, sale, and variable cost is so much, you can with this. Fixed cost into sales by sales minus variable cost, or fixed cost into sales by contribution, or total sales minus margin of safety, or fixed cost by PV ratio. This is how you can find out in any one. When you want to find out break-even point in terms of sales, you can use any one of the formula and get it. All of you, if possible, just take a picture of this and keep it with you, so that when I am doing the problem, you should be in a position to understand much better. Then another, profit volume ratio. This is a contribution to sales ratio or profit volume ratio also. See, contribution by sales is there. That also you can use. It is also called as contribution to sales ratio or profit volume ratio. You can find out change in profit by change in sales, or fixed expenses by break-even. Any one of the formulas you can use for PV ratio. Again, there is one more for margin of safety. Total sales minus break-even sales, or it is called profit by PV ratio also. You can find out, or you can, there is one more formula. Sales required to earn a desired profit. Suppose the managing director or the general manager asks you, I want this much of profit. So if you want this much of profit, what should be your sales? So that is the formula we can use it. Sales required to earn a desired profit. You want this much, so what should be your sales? The formula will be fixed expenses plus desired profit divided by contribution per unit. This is in terms of units you can use. Or expenses plus desired profit divided by PV ratio. This is in terms of sales. Either in terms of units or in terms of sales, you can use with this formula. Please, all of you will take a screenshot of this also. If PV ratio is called 20%, variable cost will be 80% of the sales. So this is how the marginal costing will be utilized. This is a formula. Now I will come back. One, before I do this, I just want to come back to this. Now, this problem is there. All of us just have a look at it. Can anyone answer? You can send it through your chat or raise your hand and tell me. Just take 2 minutes and tell me. An enthusiastic chief freight transport manager, this is one of the questions set in the LDC of a zonal railway, suggested to the general manager that if he is allowed to reduce the freight per ton of cement by 20%, you would be able to increase the traffic by 30% in the coming year. You are given the following information. Present freight per ton kilometer, I'm helping you by saying present freight per ton is nothing but, it is freight per ton is nothing but selling price. We use a word freight means what we are charging. Freight per ton means we are selling our freight, lifting the freight at the rate of 7.50 rupees per ton kilometer. If you have to move a ton, a kilometer, we are going to charge 7.50 rupees from the customer. So present level of traffic. So we are having, today we are moving 2 lakh ton kilometers at the rate of 7.50 rupees, with the total variable cost for carrying this traffic is 10,50,000, with the total fixed cost per annum is 3,60,000. Now, what would be your financial advice to the general manager? Back your advice with the profit before a price reduction, assuming the proposed increase is achieved. So, I want just first part of the question. Can anyone answer and raise your hand? We'll see. Just take 2 minutes, 1 minute and 10. So, this is how marginal costing will help you to understand. Till now, what all I spoke to you all, lectured you, I'll know how much you'll be able to analyze and take it forward, how you'll attempt the question I want. At least one of you. to yourself, welcome back. Anyway, so I'll come back to you all afterwards. I have done till here. So now a simple problem on this in marginal costing. Use this information to answer the questions below. Selling price is given 17 rupees. Fixed expenses are 1,30,000 plus 10. All of them take. The total fixed cost is 1,40,000. And variable expenses are what? Cost of the goods sold 4 and selling and admin. So he has given you information in terms of units. 4 rupees and 3 rupees variable expenses per unit. Okay. Selling price per unit and variable cost is per unit. So now what you have to do? What is your company's contribution? I told you. Sales minus variable cost. So sales is what? 17. Variable cost is how much? 7. 17 minus 7. What is the contribution? 10 rupees per unit is the cost. Selling price is 17 rupees. Variable cost is 7. So 17 minus 7 is 10. What is that? So contribution is 10. Like that you get done. This is also one of the LDC's problem. So what is the break-in point in terms of units? If you have a paper, you can write fixed cost by selling price minus variable cost. Put fixed is how much? 1,30,000 plus 10. 1,40,000. 1,40,000 divided by fixed by contribution per unit. What is the contribution? 17 minus 7, 10. So 1,40,000 divided by 10 is 14,000 units. So you got the answer here. B1. A, B, and C. So B is the answer. Similarly, if the company wants to earn a profit of 42,000 instead of break even, what is the number of units the company must sell? So this is a formula I gave you already. What is the formula I said? Sales required to earn a desired profit in terms of units. What is the formula? Fixed expenses plus desired profit by EV ratio, or fixed expense desired profit by contribution per unit. In terms of units, we will see. So what? Fixed expenses is how much? 1,40,000 plus desired profit is 42,000. So 1,40,000 plus 42,000 you make. So that will be 1,82,000 divided by contribution per unit. Contribution per unit is what? 10 rupees. So 1,82,000 divided by 10, 18,200. So you get the answer of 18,000. So this is how our formulas, if you remember this formulas, it will help you very nicely, clearly. You will be able to answer any question. One more problem. So calculate break-even point from the following figures. So if you take this, he has given in terms of rupees. So what is the formula? For the formula for the second problem, you take this formula. You take this. F into S by S minus V, fixed expense sales by sale, or fixed expenses into sales by cost. You take the first one. Fixed expenses into sales by sales divided by variable. So you go. Fixed expenses are much? 70. F into S. 70,000 into 3 lakhs divided by selling price 3 lakhs minus 2 lakhs. Your variable cost is 2 lakhs. Direct material, direct labor and direct expenses are 2 lakhs. So 3 lakhs minus 2 lakhs is what? 1 lakh. 1 lakh divided by 3 lakhs. 3 lakhs into 75 divided by 1 lakh. 1 lakh goes 3 times. 3 lakh, 3 into 75 is 2 lakhs 25. Easily you will get the answer with the help of what? Formula. Keep this question also with you. If you have any in my interaction section, okay, when we are clearing your doubts, clarification. Calculate the break-in point from the following figures. Fixed expenses is 3 lakhs, variable cost is 7. So this we have to use in terms of units. Fixed expenses by selling price minus variable cost. So fixed expense is 3 lakhs, selling price 16 minus 2 is, selling expense, sorry. Variable cost per unit and selling expenses. So 2 is what? 18 lakhs. This is 1. 20. Selling price 21, variable cost is 16. So 3 lakh divided by 5 is 16. Yeah, that is correct. Okay. No, selling price is fixed expense by selling price minus variable cost. 21 minus 16 is 5. So 3 lakhs by 5 you get 5,000. 16,000 into 6. If you make it a selling price 21, you get this much. 21,60,000. Okay. So this is how you find it, the variable cost marginal break-in point in terms of units, in terms of sales, these two problems. Now, the department has total cost of 80,000 in a recent month. When it purchased 18,000 units, in another recent month, it processed 15,000 units. And its total cost was 71,000. So they are asking you, what is the departmental variable cost per unit processed, and the department's fixed cost per month. So how do we do? You take, you try to make a note of it. You have to make. I'll just try to make you understand this is small one. So, when we are making the department total cost are 80,000 units for 18,000, when you are making 15,000 units, so if you make 15,000 units, your total cost is 71,000. But if you are making 18,000 units, your total cost is 80,000 units. So, the difference is what? For 3,000 units, the difference is 9,000. So, you can make a variable cost per unit, you can find out like variable cost per unit will change in cost divided by change in units. Change in cost will change in. So it will be like so simple. You remember. What is the change in cost? Change in cost is 9,000. By change in units is 3,000. So it is 3 rupees per unit. So like this it can. If you want, you can do verification. So verification, the total cost per 18,000 units is 80,000. So, the total cost for 18,000 units is 80,000. In this 18,000, we take like this. 18,000 into 3. The variable cost will be 54,000. Variable cost. cost? Variable cost? Variable cost is $54. The remaining will be fixed cost. Will be 54. Will be 26,000. Similarly, if you check up. Similarly for. 15,000 units, the total cost is how much? 71,000 will go. Then variable cost is for 15,000 units. Cost should also be 26,000. See, you add this, so you can understand fixed cost here is not changing. Fixed cost is here 26,000. Here also fixed cost is how much? 20,000. So like, so whether you make 18,000 or 15,000, your fixed cost will remain same. So how do you find out the for 18,000 units it is 80,000, for 15,000 units it is 71,000. So the is it for so units of 3,000 the differential cost is 9. So always the difference cost is called variable cost per unit. If you make it, change in cost divided by change in units, you get 3 rupees. So this is how you have to understand your marginal costing thing. Application of marginal costing and cost volume profit analysis. So marginal costing is very useful tool for management because of the its following important applications. One is cost control. Very important is what now? I am talking about cost control. Marginal costing divides the total cost into fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed cost can be controlled by the top management and that to a limited extent. Variable cost can be controlled by the lower level of cost. This is for your information, theoretical part. Then profit planning. It also helps in what? Profit planning. Marginal cost helps in profit planning, that is planning for future operations such a way as to maximize profits or to maintain a specified level of profit. Absorption costing is nothing but marginal costing, total costing, which fails to bring out the correct effect of change in the sale price, variable cost or product price in the profits of a concern. So this is an illustration I am making it for profit making. See, two businesses Y Limited and Z Limited sell the same type of product in the same market. Their budgeted profit and loss accounts for the coming year are as follows. Y Limited is selling for 1,50,000. You can see from the slide, the sales of Y and Z Limited are same. But their variable costs are different, their fixed costs are different, but their profit again back to same. So what he wants you to tell, break-even point of each product. So we know the formula. Break-even point, how do you find out? Here, I made break, you know, fixed expenses into sales by sales minus variable cost. If you put fixed expenses of A is 15,15,000. Your sales is 1,50,000. Again, sales is 1,50,000 minus variable cost is 1,20,000. You get what? 75,000 is a break. Similarly, for B also you can do it like that. So this is how it helps us. Sales at which each business will earn a profit of 5,000. So what formula we use? Sales at which each business will earn a profit of 5,000 means we make fixed expenses plus desired profit by a PV ratio. So how to find out the PV ratio? PV ratio formula I gave you. Contribution by sales. What is your contribution? 30,000. By sales is what? 30 by 1,50,000. 1/5 or 0.2. 20% or 20.2. You put that formula, you get the answer here. But this also is it. Then calculate the at which sales volume both earn equal profit. One for the both are have to sell 1,50,000 to make their profit 15,000. This way the formula help also you can do. Orally you can, by seeing like this also you can do. Evaluation of performance. So the different products, departments and sales division have different profit earning potentials. See, every organization, every company will have different departments, different, their sales will be different and all. So marginal costing analysis is very useful for evaluating the performance of each sector of a concern. So which sector, which division is doing very good profit. Now in railways, we have to know which division is doing what, which of the zone. Indian Railways, Railway Board may be interested in knowing which railway is doing very good. So they take operating ratio as one of the, tool. Operating ratio is one of the important ratio to find out which railway is doing. Railway, we take the operating ratio and find out which division is doing right. So this is how we have to find out. So performance evaluation is better done if distinction is made between fixed and when. I am going on using that word from the beginning of the session, that an organization should be in a position to classify their cost into fixed cost and variable cost. If you are not able to differentiate between fixed cost and variable cost, it will be difficult. A product giving higher contribution should be preferred if fixed expenses remain same. So I just put one small on that. So which product you should have, which product you should eliminate, a product or continue product. For example, I will tell A, B, C, there are three products are there which I am going to teach in the example. Before, without showing, I will ask you, if product B is making a loss, so people, and some people without having any knowledge of marginal costing, they may say you drop the product B or eliminate the product B, you say. But we should not do that. As long as a product is giving, for example, one more example, I just teach you, if A and B, two friends are staying in a room and the fixed, the rent they are paying is 5,000 each. If because of some reason, if A says, A asks B to get out of the room, indirectly, A has to pay the entire rent of 10,000 will fall on his head. So they have to consider like that. As long as someone is contributing towards your fixed cost, that person should not be eliminated. Or that product should not be discontinued or eliminated. Because if you remove that product, if you discontinue with that product or eliminate that product, the entire fixed expenses have to be borne by the other products. So you should be very careful in dropping a product or eliminating a product, considering that. I hope you will be able to understand with my example. See, now if you can see, all of you, I gave that example, carefully understand this. A company having three products gives the following information. Product A, product B, product C. 60,000 is this. Their variable costs have been given as 6,000, 15,000 and 20,000. So each is contributing of 4,000, B is contributing 5,000, C is contributing 5,000. So the total contribution we are getting around 19,000. and the total fixed cost is 375, we are getting 15,000 per. So, though A is making a profit of 1,000, B is making a loss of 2,000 if you do it, and C is making a 5,000. Overall, the company is making a profit of 4,000. So, the general manager says, he says he wants a finance manager to drop the product B as it is giving a loss of 2,000. On the face of it, if you see, if you remove product B, you will get a profit of 6,000 because this 2,000 is being eaten away by product B. But what I want all of you to understand is product B is contributing 5,000 towards your fixed cost. There is a fixed cost 7,000, it is contributing 5. If you drop the product B, to the extent of 5,000 contribution, have to be, this fixed, though there is 7,000 fixed cost, this has to go on by these two people. Or to the extent of 5,000, is being contributed by B. So this 5,000 contribution, if it is gone, your profit from 4,000 between come to a loss of 1,000. So this is how it looks. See here. The total fixed cost finally you have to bear it. Whether A will bear or B, C will bear, we do not know how much. But the total fixed cost which is there, 15,000, if the 7,000 fixed cost have to be borne by these two products, A and C, indirectly what happens from 19, this 5,000 will not be there. Your contribution will become 14,000. Because these two are contributing 4 and 10, 14. But your fixed cost will be 15. So there is a loss of how much? 1,000. So this is very, very important. So what I want you to understand, see, if the finance manager drops the product B as advised by the general manager, the overall position from profit of 5,000 will end in a loss of what? 1,000. So it is advised if product B was contributing 5,000 towards fixed cost, it should not be, as it is advised if product B is gone, not worth. Product B is contributing rupees 5,000. It is advised that product B is contributing rupees towards fixed cost, hence it should not be dropped. Like this you have to write. So we have to understand. So by just looking at the product, product B is giving a loss of 2,000, we want to drop it, it will be wrong. Because the product is contributing 5,000 towards your fixed cost. If you remove this product B, your entire 1,000 of contribution will be lost and your profit will be lost. From 4,000, the contribution is gone 5,000. So it will be a loss of what? 1,000 rupees loss here. So you should be careful. Whenever a product is contributing towards your fixed cost, the product should not be dropped. You please remember this very, very important point. As long as a product is contributing towards fixed cost, the product should not be dropped. So, plus the decision making, one more. So, the information provided by the total cost method is not sufficient in solving the management. Because marginal costing technique is used in aiding the management in vital decision making. What are those vital decision making? See, the following important areas where managerial problems are simplified by use of the marginal costing. How to fix the selling price? What should be the selling price? You should know. Key and limiting factor. See, I want all of you to understand key and limiting factor are what. For example, I'll tell you before I go into the limiting factor, a small example I would like to give. During Diwali time, if you are selling crackers on one single day, you buy for 1 lakh, sell for 2 lakhs. So you are making a profit of 1 lakh rupees on one single day. So why don't you consider selling the crackers throughout the year? You cannot sell because the limiting factor is what? It is seasonal. You can sell only on Diwali day or 1 day or 2 days. You cannot sell your crackers throughout the year. So that is called the limiting factor. So whenever you are taking some managerial problems, in marginal costing, you should keep in your mind what are the key factors and what are the limiting factors. Key factor is what? Contribution is the key factor. The more the contribution, the more the profit. So you should check up what is the contribution. That will be the key factor. And limiting factors are what? whether it is seasonal, whether the material is available, whether the labor is available, which is in short supply, whether we'll get power or not, whether there is a demand or not, whether the consumers are not, so many things are there. So we have to understand the factors while you take a decision. So make or buy a decision, already I told you, I do have a small problem and show it to you. Should you make a product or buy a product? Choose a good product mix. If you choose a good product mix, what should be it? See, now railways are running AC 210, AC 310, first class or second class, sleeper class. So we should know in which route we should have this AC first class. In a remote area where even a small line is there, if you go for villages, there you should not have AC first class. No one will travel there. They cannot afford it. So you should understand which line you should put, which areas you should put, what to put, where to put, all that, you know, what should be a good product mix. You should understand that. Effect of change in selling price. If the selling price is increased, the demand will drop. For example, now during our COVID times also, you can see as this selling price of petrol is going on increasing, but there is no change in your demand. Demand is same, selling price. Selling price, when it was 6 rupees also, people were traveling, 60 also, 80 also, 90 also, people will talk for a day or two and continue. So there are certain products which does not have change in this, will not have any change in the selling price. It will continue to have the same demand, same thing. So we should put what product we are going for. So I have made a small problem on that also to make you understand. Maintaining a desired level of profit. So we want to have this much of profit. So what should be our sales? What should be our profit? Then alternative methods of production. That also I made one. What are the alternative methods of production? Whether you should manually or whether you should do sophisticated machinery or change in machinery. So many things are there. But at the bottom line for all these things, when you are doing all these things, whether you are making profit more than what we are making now. That should. So, diversification of product. Should you diversify or not? With the change in the people's mind, the change in the customs, change in this thing, change in account, so many things. We should see whether our product will continue to have demand or not. So, otherwise, we should diversify our products. So, these are all the important areas. I will discuss one after one. Fixation of selling price. My decision relating to determination of optimum selling price. So what should be your maximum selling price? See, for a product, even for petrol today, suddenly from 100, if you make 1000 rupees, no one will buy. So slowly 2 rupees, 1 rupee, 2 rupees, 1 rupee, you are making, that's going on. So this manage decision related determination of optimum selling price, at what price you should do, you should be careful in fixing the optimum. So determining the optimum selling price of any product or service is a big challenge. We should suddenly increase the price, then the demand will drop. We should be careful for a manager of any company, because company wants to make profit from each unit of it. So finally what? If you increase or decrease your selling price, the main motive of doing that is to make the profit. Whether you may suddenly increase the selling price, which is beyond the people's pocket, no one will buy, and at the end of the day you will end up with a loss. So you should be careful. So that is a big challenge of fixing the selling price. In marginal costing technique, fixed cost will not be changed. That you should remember at any level of production. Whatever level of production is there, your fixed cost will be same. Only the variable cost is changed for getting optimum selling price where company can achieve expected profit. Example. Suppose a company wants to earn 15% net profit margin, means they want a profit of 15% on the net profit margin, means on the selling price. Please remember, what's a 15% when nothing is mentioned, net profit margin means on the selling price. Because of ratio analysis when you do, your gross profit ratio will be gross profit by sales increment, means related to sales. Net profit ratio is what? Net profit divided by sales, means related to sales. So whenever they say 15% net profit, means it should be on the sales margin on 20,000 units sold. If you sell 20,000 units, we need to get a 15% profit. So what price will the company? So this is a big challenge. So how marginal costing will help us? We'll see. Fixed cost is given as 180,000 and the variable cost is 25 rupees per kg. Am I clear? So 180 is a fixed cost, variable cost is 25. So number of units expected to sell at desired profit. So I gave one formula: fixed expenses plus desired profit contribution per unit. This is a formula you should use. If you can use this formula, fixed expense, desired profit, this formula you use it, then you will understand. So, fixed expense plus desired profit by contribution per unit, you use it. The sales, number of units expected to sell, is at what? 20,000 units you have to sell. If 20,000 units you have to sell, your fixed cost is 180,000 plus desired profit is what? 15% of your sales. 20,000 is your selling price. Your selling price is what? Fixed expenses are 180,000. Okay. And your sales are what? 15% of your 20,000. Okay. So 20,000 if you are selling, your fixed cost are 180,000 plus desired profit will be 15% of your sales selling price. 20,000 into selling price, that is your desired profit. Your profit is should be equal to 20,000 into selling price. Whatever selling price you are making. Okay. So 15,000 into your selling price divided by selling price. Contribution per unit is called selling price minus variable cost. Variable cost per unit will be a pretty. So if you equate that, you know, you bring that selling price 20,000 into, you bring this 15, selling price minus 25, you bring this side. This 180,000 you put it here plus 15% of selling price you make. So you will get, if you do calculations, you will get your answer. 20,000 into selling price minus 25 will be 20,000 selling price minus 20,000 into 25 will be 5 lakhs equal to 180,000 plus 15% of 20,000 is 3,000 into selling price, 3,000 selling. So this 20,000 selling price minus 3,000 selling price, you bring this side, you get 180 minus this 5 lakhs plus 5 lakhs. So this will be 7, selling price is called 6,80,000. Selling price is 6,80,000 divided by 70 is 40,000, or expected selling price is 40 rupees per unit. If you are, that means what he says, what the question was, what will be the price with the company? 40 rupees selling. If you make 40 rupees selling price, you get the answer. If you want, I'll just make verify it. So if you make 20,000 units, if you are selling 20,000 units, into selling price how much? What we got answer. Your sales will be how much? 8 lakhs. This is your sales. Our sales will be this. Then from the sales you minus variable cost. Sales minus variable cost. Variable cost will be how much? 20,000 into variable cost is 20 UT. So you think 6 lakh variable cost will be 2500. We are verifying the answer whether bond or not answer is correct. So your contribution will be how much? Contribution will be 3 lakhs. Your contribution will be 3 lakhs. So, and your fixed cost is how much? You take 180,000. Then your profit will be 1,20,000. So what you wanted? You wanted 15% on your sales. When you sell 15% margin on your sales, if you are selling 20,000 units, what should be the selling price? If you sell 40 rupees at that time, 40 rupees if you are 8, from 8 lakhs, if you take 15% of 8 lakhs will be how much? This is almost your profit. Profit is almost 15% of sales. Exactly, it will come. We have verified, we proved the answer. Your profit is 1,20,000, which is equal to 15% sales. So like this, we have to understand what he says. A small, though he says 15%, we did not know what is the selling price. With the formula, if you do, exactly we get 40 rupees. And if you verify, you get your answer is correct. Exactly, you get 1,20,000. Is now your another problem is what? A key factor is that factor which puts limit on production and profit. Usually a limiting factor is sales. A concern may not be able to sell as much as it can produce, but sometimes a concern can sell all its produces. The production is limited due to shortage of materials, labor, plant capacity or capital. In such a case, a decision must be taken regarding the choice of product, whose production is to be increased, which product is to be increased or which product is to be reduced or which product has to be stopped. Ordinarily, when there is no limiting factor, the choice of product will be based on the highest PV ratio. But when there are scarce or limited resources, selection of product will be based on contribution per unit of scarce factor product. Examples. This slide here. Just all of you see the products. Suppose our XYZ products are AC210, AC310 and sleeper class are there. Your raw materials per unit is what, your variable cost to maintain that, to run that, you need material, labor and other variable cost, which is costing you 27,000, and you are able to sell for 30 rupees per unit. Okay, so 30, so how do we go over? You are getting 30 minus selling price minus variable cost, 30 minus 27, you are getting 3 rupees variable cost contribution per unit. For the Y product, you are getting 40 minus 38, you get 2 rupees. And for the Z, you are getting 60 minus 48, 12. So, which is good, you are thinking? You may think Z product is good. But Z product is taking 6 hours. So, 12 by 6 is what? You are getting only 2 rupees per hour. And here, you are getting in Y product, you are getting 2 rupees contribution. But it is taking only half an hour, means 0.5 hours. So, 2 rupees by 0.5, 4 rupees per hour it is getting. And here you are getting 3 rupees. 3 divided by 3 is what? 1 rupee per hour. So that is how the contribution per hour. So this is very important. So I put it. Sales minus variable cost, you are getting contribution. So you, if you see at you are telling Z is a good, but but Z is taking 6 hours to do the product. So it is giving only 2 rupees per hour. So we have to see very important in view of the above product, in view of the above, okay, Y. Which one? Product Y has to be thought of it, not to be. Has to be, and it is maximum contribution per hour. Now make or buy is there. Can you, already I told you, utilize its idle capacity by making component parts instead of buying them from market. In arriving at such a make or buy decision, the price should be compared with the marginal cost of producing one. So already I discussed this with you, making one small example I made. So, yes, radio manufacturing company finds that while its cost is 6 rupees each to make the component X, the same is available in the market at rupees 560 with an assurance of continuous supply. The breakdown of the cost. The breakdown of the cost is 560 available. Okay, with an assurance of continuous supply, the breakdown of cost is as well. Material 2 rupees directly, the other variable is 50, depreciation and other fixed cost is 1. So, depreciation and fixed cost is 1 rupee. Should the company make or buy? So, if you take depreciation and variable cost is 5 rupees and depreciation is 1, 6 rupees. If you buy the product from the market 560 plus 1 rupee, it will become 660. So, should the company make or buy? Give also your advice in case the suppliers reduce the price from 560 to 460. So, if it is 560, you should not buy it, you should make. Because 560 plus 1 rupee, it is going to cost you 660. But if the same thing, if the suppliers reduce from 560 to 460, 460 plus 1 rupee, it will be 560. Making is 6 rupees and buying is 560. So, in this case, in the first case, you should make it, in the second case, you should buy it. So, that's why I made it. If the product is made in a company, the following is a cost. So, I made. The variable cost is 5 rupees. Depreciation and fixed cost is 1. The total cost is 6 rupees. If the same is bought, it's 560 plus 1, 660. In view of the above, it is better to make that buy. But if the same is available for 460, then it is better to buy the product. So, this is all make or buy decision. The fixed cost, we make the decision, you know. You have to take a decision. If you can classify the total cost into fixed cost and variable, your fixed cost will remain with you, 1 rupee. If you are buying for 560 plus 1 rupee, it is going to cost you 660. If the same is available for 460, 460 plus 1, it will be 560. In the second case, you should buy it. In the first case, you should make. So, this is how we come to. Another choosing a good product mix. So, which product will give maximum contribution? You can take like same thing example. See, we are making two products. A and B are there. Direct material, direct wages and selling price is there. But the variable overheads are allocated to product as 100% of direct wages. So, 10 rupees, plus 3 rupees 13 plus 100% of 3 is what? 3. So your variable cost is 16. So 20 minus 16 is 4 rupees contribution E is giving. Similarly, B is giving how much? 15 rupees. Same. Variable cost 9 plus 2, 11 plus another 2 because 100%. 11 plus 9, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 2, 13. So 15 minus 13 is 2. Here you are getting 4, here you are getting 2. So in this, what should be your best sales mix? Should you sell 1000 units of product A and 2000 of B, 1500 of A and 1500 of B, or 2000 of A and 1000 of B? So which should be your best product mix? So first you should make selling price minus variable cost, you get contribution 4 and 2. So the total contribution should be what? Product A, 1000 into 4, 4000, 2000 into 2, 4000. The total contribution is 8000. From 8000 you minus the total fixed cost, which is fixed will not change. See, here he says the fixed cost is 6. Whatever sales mix is there, your contribution will be 6. So your profit is 2000 in the first case, in the first mix. In the second mix, if it is 9000, it is fixed cost is 6, you are getting a profit of 3000. And in the third mix, your profit is 4. So from the above it can be seen that sales mix C is the best, as the maximum profit is generated from it. That means product A, 2000 you should sell of A and 1000 of A. And I want you to remember here, as long as you are getting within the product, whichever is giving you the maximum contribution, you should try to sell that product, because the contribution will become the key factor. Is it clear, all of you? Can I get into the question answer mode? Your questions, your doubts? Another 15 minutes is there. Yes, anyone? Anshara Garu? Anyone is there? Anyone having any doubts, please? Nagishara Garu, anyone, please interact? I'm audible. Mr. Nagishara. Mr. Subramani,
Sir, one minute.
Yes. Now what I should do, is there anyone having doubt? Someone asked some different, they were asking, how do I interact with them?
Sir, please tell me, sir.
If anyone having any doubt, someone was asking me to tell difference between some financial accounting and management, some question they asked. And someone, Amit Kumar, is asking something. How do I interact with him?
Yeah, sir, I'll unmute, sir.
Yeah, unmute him.
Questions, all are unmuted. Please ask questions to faculty. Please ask queries to faculty.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, can you explain difference between financial accounting and management accounting?
Yes. Financial accounting, you know, the main work of financial accounting, you know, it collects the data. Listen, it collects the data, classifies the data, you know. See, there's an accounting cycle, journal entries, ledger posting, trial balance, everything is there. That is the job of the financial accounting. It classifies the data into all that. Once the accounting is done, management accounting takes into account all the information, and whatever information is required for the management, it comprises what is the fixed cost, what is the variable cost, what is the total cost, what is the profit, whether this firm. That is a decision of the management.
Thank you, sir.
Anyone having still any doubt?
Sir, we have a question, sir.
Sir, yes,
sir. What is difference between cost accounting and management accounting, sir?
See, management accounting and cost accounting are both are branches of accounting.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what happens in costing, it collects the data and classifies it, it makes it to cost centers, profit center, you know, it collects what is your material cost, what is your labor cost. So, that information is required for the management for decision making. For example, to make a product, it is costing you 10 rupees, I just told you, see. The costing is what? It will collect the data and the total cost of a product is 10 rupees. But you are making the, you want to buy a product for 9 rupees, should you make it or buy it? That making that decision, costing is required. So cost has taken it, the cost will generate what is the total cost and divides the cost into variable cost, what is the fixed cost, all that. So that is the importance of cost.
Thank you, sir.
Management accounting is what? It makes management account what? Takes this data into account, then it will plan for you. What is the planning? It will forecast. It will say, should you make a product or not? So many things. With the help of the information, it takes the decision. Having information is one part. It's a big challenge for decision making. So that is why the difference between art and a science is what? Having the information is what? It's a science. You are having the data. But taking a decision, depending upon the fact, I should take the decision may be correct, maybe it may not be correct later. So that is how it goes on. Tell, anything else?
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Please, yes.
Sir, how to use in railway for traffic posting, for a marginal posting, sir?
Sorry, which costing?
Traffic posting, sir. In railway, in traffic posting, how to use marginal posting?
Marginal costing only utilized in railways as long as the total cost of the your costing has to be segregated into fixed cost and variable cost, without which you cannot. We are not having that kind of costing now in railways. We are having what type of costing? The traffic costing, what do we do, you know? We do, it is that word I'm just not getting it. We have that. What is that, I'm sure that what that costing, railways, we use?
Costing we use, still marginal costing.
No, marginal costing we cannot use straight away because we cannot differentiate between fixed cost and variable cost at all. We have that, what is that costing we use, the total cost? Fully distributed cost. That cost is fully distributed, that kind of costing is used. We are not using marginal costing because we have to have that perfect tool to classify our entire costing into fixed cost and variable cost. Unless that is done, we cannot do that. It is a fully distributed costing method. Anything else? Yes, please. I just wanted all of you, did you understand that about my traffic manager, you know, general manager requested the GM to increase the sales by decreasing the selling price. He wanted to increase the output. Did you understand that problem which is related to? Yes, please.
Now, please respond, participants.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, please.
Hello, sir.
Anyone having any thoughts?
Sir, how is traffic posting data used in financial justification of new line project?
That I'm not aware of it. How?
Traffic posting data, sir.
That will be answered by some other professor. How they are using it? I'm not connected with that.
Oh.
And the marginal costing, as per the commercial undertaking, I said I gave you the broad outlines of marginal costing techniques, how they are used in decision making. Traffic costing, I have not been aware of it.
Sir, please
explain the difference. You can make this note and...
The cost costing also, it is like the margin costing on this,
sir.
In calculation of this topic, projections, asset projections.
Okay.
But here we have calculated the cost of the service, that is, we use profit costing.
Any other question, please, related to this session? What?
Now, let me separately what session on the topic costing.
Yeah, that would be much better. The topic costing, how it is done, and how it is related to railways. You can do that one session in depth.
Okay.
Any other question related to these things, what I have done, what I have shared my slides on that, any questions you are having, please feel free to ask.
I think there are no questions for the participants. We'll wait for a minute and then end the session, sir.
Okay.
There are any doubts from that side?
Okay.
पहली बार हम क्वेश्चन पूछे
ओके वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव एंड यूजफुल सर थैंक यू फॉर शेयरिंग योर
नॉलेज कॉस्ट एंड नॉलेज का मैनेजमेंट तो शॉर्ट में बताया है लिस्ट लिखा हुआ है जानते हैं ये सब लेक्चर अटेंड करने से क्या है कुछ कुछ दिमाग में घुसता है
सर Now I think we'll wind up. Sir, that was very informative and useful. Thank you for sharing your knowledge and enlightening us on the subject, sir. On behalf of the Academy, I thank you, sir. I thank all the participants. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.